Welcome back, friends. Until last video, we have seen various mechanism of Markita framework, how to test the, how to mark the object. Okay. In this video, we're going to see how to mark, how to test layer by layer. For example, let's say the inventory project, in our inventory project, the product service test, right? When you open up Markita product service test, we have marked product DOI MPL, right? We marked the product DOI MPL, then we tested a service layer. I want to test the service layer. Then I want to mark the product DOI MPL. Why? Because when I call the get product by ID, it will call the database. I don't want to connect database without connecting database. I want to test only the get product by ID that implemented in product service class. That part we have seen here. Okay. Now, if you develop a project, right, that project will have several layers. For example, let's say our application, inventory application, it's a very small inventory application. That application contains controller layer, product manager service, that is service layer, then DAO layer. I have created one more new class called product manager service. Okay. I don't want to disturb existing class. That's the reason I created another service class called product manager service. Okay. There is a three layer, controller layer, service layer, and a DAO layer. Okay. Now I want to test only control layer. I don't want to test service layer. Then I want to test only service layer. I don't want to connect with control layer. I don't want to connect with DAO layer. I want to test only product manager service. Whatever method implemented inside a product manager service, I want to test that method alone. Whatever method implemented, whatever REST API implemented in control layer, I want to test only that REST API method. I don't want to test service class. Similarly, DAO layer. In DAO layer, I want to test only the DAO methods. But let me open a product controller here. This product controller highly depends on product manager service. When you look at here, there is a five method, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I don't want to explain this method implementation because there are several videos I posted already about the crude operation. These are just a crude operation. Inventory crude operation, product crude operation, adding a new product, view existing product by providing product ID, then get all products, then update products by providing a particular product ID, then delete product. This is a crude operation API. I want to join it. I want to test only this method. But whenever call this method, what will happen? My product manager service called by add product, right? So this add product highly depends on product manager service. When you call this method, definitely we make sure that product manager service also available. Okay. But when you do the JNU test cases, the service is not available because we are not loading the entire Spring Boot application. So this product manager service is not available. Okay. It will be null. It will throw the null point exception. At the same time, I don't want to check whatever method implemented inside the save method also. I don't want to check, don't want to test whatever coding implemented inside the save method. I want to check only the code implemented in add product. So I really don't want to test this save. So I want to bypass this. For that, we need to mock. I want to mock this product manager service. Sim, product manager service. Then I want to test only this method. Then, after testing a control layer, similarly, I want to test only service class. Okay. When you open a service class, the service class depends on product repository. So I want to test only whatever logic implemented here. I want to test only whatever logic implemented service methods. I want to test that. So I want to mock repository class. By mocking repository class, we can test only product manager service without depending on the DAO layer. Similarly, by mocking product manager service, I can test only control layer without depending on product manager service. Similarly, DAO layer also we can test like that. That part we're going to implement. Before start that, we're going to check these methods are working properly or not. Which method? This APIs. Okay.
What is that API? API products. If you call API products, I can add new product. If you call API products by passing ID, I can view a product. If you call the same URL API products by passing get mapping, by using get method, we'll get all products. If you pass the same URL very similar to get mapping, if you pass the same URL for put mapping, it will go into update. If you pass product ID by passing delete mapping, by selecting a delete method, it will delete a record. Okay, this code operation we're going to check now.
API products. Now here, what is the request attribute? Request attribute is name, description, and the price. Only we need to input name, description, and the price. Okay, this tax total price calculated by our logic. Okay. Name. Mango. Okay, this is the request body. I am going to send the request to add a product. So new product added. See, 201 created, new product got added. New product got added, right? When you check the database, you can see new product get added. I will go and add one more product. Added. See here. Okay, now we're going to check other APIs. If you select a get method, what will happen? It will return all the product. See, return all the product. If you pass 6 here, return 6th product. If you pass the delete, if you select delete, this product get deleted. What happened? Product. Hey, here is a spelling mistake, I think. It's a spelling mistake. That is a problem. Restarting the application now. Still we have a 6th record. Path variable spelling is mismatching, right? That's the reason it's not working rate mapping, okay? Okay, now I'm going to delete. Still server is not started or what? The server is just not started. Just starting. It's not completed to start. Okay, it's just starting. Yeah, server started. Now I'm going to send the request, delete request. I want to delete this product. I got the 200, okay. We don't get any response. Let me check the AB. Yes, I got this. 6 record is edited. Okay. Now what we want to test now? For example, let's say if we see post method. In the post method, if you pass some data, for example, Apple. So whenever I send this request to the post method, what's happening? What's happening? It's creating a new record in database. It's creating a new record in database, and that record returning as a response here. Whenever test only controller class using JUnit, I want to get this response. I don't want to check service class logic and what's happening in the product view. I don't want to care about those classes. Whenever call this particular method, whenever call this particular method, I want to make sure that this response is coming. For that, we need to test only controller class. No need to test service class and dual layer, right? So that we need to mark this service class. By marking the service class, we can check only response. Our response is returned by this method is correctly or not. That part only I need to test. For that, we need to mark. So that particular test we are going to test. Okay. Layer by layer. Okay. Please take this code from the repository. We're going to continue that testing part in the next video. Okay. Until then, bye-bye from Suresh. Still not subscribe this channel? Please subscribe it. Share this video to your friend circle. Click bell icon for regular updates. Thanks for watching this full video.